Welcome to Schein Chats. My name is Bruce Lieberthal, and I serve as the Vice President and Chief Innovation Officer here at Henry Schein. Today, I'm thrilled to be joined by Florian Hillen, who's the very talented CEO and founder of VideaHealth, a brilliant young dental artificial intelligence company with great technology and a sincere mission to improve patient health. Florian, thank you for joining us today. I think you'll agree artificial intelligence is an exciting advancement in technology with applications in dentistry, which we're going to explore today. Let's start off with, what is AI? What makes it so fascinating?
Yeah. Thank you, Bruce, for having me. And hello, everyone. So what is AI? Actually, it's not super well defined. It's really more an overarching term of artificial intelligence. But you can think about this in maybe three wider categories. The first one would be AI as it pertains to ranking different lists and preferences, which is, for instance, Google or Netflix, that when you are watching a specific show, it learns your behavior about the show, and then it can automatically recommend you other shows you might like as well. That's one way of AI. Another way of AI, and usually what we mean by this is machine learning of training data and giving inputs and outputs, would be natural language processing. So that would be your Alexa or your Siri about like, hey, how is the weather like today? And then the third, and I believe obviously most interesting type of AI would be computer vision. So based on imaging. And here you could imagine, for instance, autonomous driving, or in our domain, automatically identifying disease in images, for instance, which we come to in a second. Now, what makes this also fascinating, and you see this right now, is all these examples I gave you right now, they're impacting your life in this moment. But then also, they are all exponential in terms of the impact. And you just recently have seen this with ChatGPT, where it has a significant, all of a sudden, everyone was working on something like that for the last 10 years. And now all of a sudden, it hit a chasm where now it has a huge impact. And I do believe we will say the same in different categories like imaging AI and so on in the near future as well.
Yeah, yeah, couldn't agree with you more. All of a sudden, GPT has everybody's attention. You know, we've known each other for a number of years now, and as we've worked together, and I find your story just so interesting. Could you tell us a little bit about your journey and how you found yourself to dentistry and AI in dentistry specifically?
Yeah, so I started off my career in Germany. I have a slight accent, so that's from there. And I actually studied medicine in Munich for 6 years. And the first 2 years in German medical school, I actually very closely with also the dental students. So I had to learn all of this. And then also the healthcare system in Europe, for instance, my insurance, as an example, defines healthcare with dentistry in it. And so for me, dentistry was always defined as healthcare. Never thought about this as a separate thing. That's the one component. And then the other component is that I dropped out shortly before getting my MD. And my parents are very proud about that. And the reason was because I love the patient contact and what you can do. But what fascinates me so much about technology is that you can have a meaningful impact on millions, if not even billions of people. And so that's why I dropped out and back in the days founded my first company, which was in gynecology. I then moved to San Francisco to work there for Echo Health, which was in cardiology. And then I decided, okay, I need to understand technology better because I understood the healthcare part, but not really the technology. So I went to MIT to study computer science. And my work was actually in breast cancer detection and pneumothorax, so in chest x-rays. And I was doing then very deep research actually on dental AI. How good are dentists reading radiographs and could we improve them? And I fell absolutely in love with dentistry because I truly believe it's one of the few areas where technology, patients, and dentists have a win-win-win situation. And we talk about this a little bit more, but very excited about this field for the last 6 years at this point.
Yeah, and this is a great segue, really, to my next question, really, which is, from your perspective, what is the role of AI in dentistry? How are we using, you know, sometimes I'm in conversations with people and we look at these brilliant technologies like GPT or blockchain and so on, but it's hard for us to transition to, so what are the practical uses? In dental, I think you and I, you know, are of one mind that there's some really terrific practical uses of AI in dentistry. Talk about that a little bit, if you would.
Yeah. And I just mentioned on the win-win-win for the dental practice, the patient, and even the technology, so to say, and I truly believe in it, because AI has a supporting, enabling, elevating role in dentistry. And what I mean by that is that the dentist has really four jobs, right? He is a diagnostician or she, a surgeon, a primary care physician, and a business person all in one. So that's pretty overwhelming. And so where I think AI can come in is in several domains, but specifically portraying to dental AI and imaging. If you are not, you know, in your hectic day, you're not diagnosing on top of the value chain correctly, and you're not, you're missing the periapical lesion or the small interproximal decay, then you never get to the meat of it, which is the patient communication, the treatment planning, and then also conducting the treatment. And so I think what we found is a really supporting role of AI, where it can quickly visualize, for instance, the diseases. In the end, though, the dentist always has the final purview of this. The dentist will always make the final determination, because she or he has much more information about the patient, and then he or she does the treatment plan and then also the treatment. But the AI helps them to not miss anything, and also to save time, because it quickly points out different areas of disease which should be paid extra attention to, as well as it supports the dentist and the hygienist to present the treatment plan and the diagnosis to the patient, because they got a second ad hoc opinion right while they're in a chair.
So, you know, that's a good segue also to another, I think, important question, not just for dentistry, but, you know, about AI in general, where, you know, we imagine these robots, you know, sort of taking over our world, and we're not necessary anymore. Talk to us a little bit about this sense that what AI could do is take over the role of the dentist and the hygienist. That isn't true, but how do you address that?
Yeah, I think Hollywood did us there a disservice, to be honest, because it's just more exciting to have a Terminator view, a movie, right? But what's so beautiful on this, I've been really long at this and published papers about this and so on. And what you really see is actually what the AI is really good in is pretty hard for a dentist. So what I mean by that is, you know, the AI is never tired, never has a bad day, is always the same level of attention. And that's not us, let's face it. On the other side, a dentist is much, much better off looking at the information holistically, not just narrow, knowing the patient, right? Making assessments which go beyond the imaging alone. And so what we truly see in the data is that the dentist and the AI working together as a hybrid, you know, the dentist here, the AI is here, but together they are there. That's really what we are seeing. And so I never believe that the AI will replace a dentist. In fact, especially in dentistry, we are reading radiographs to point out disease, to offer ad hoc second opinion and validate and support. But in the end, the communication with the patient as well as the treatment is always done by the dentist. And so, again, I go back to this win-win-win situation in dentistry and AI. And I actually do believe, if I can say so, Bruce, that dentistry will be the forefront industry when it comes to deployment of AI in the next 3 years. I firmly believe in that.
Yeah, I actually, you know, I work on the medical and dental side, and I couldn't agree with you more. And we use this term clinical decision support, not clinical decisions. The AI is a tool, right, helping the doctor make decisions.
We do detections. If we are very specific, we do detections. So we point out on the clinical imaging radiographic bone loss, decay. We can also show the depth of decay or the millimeter of bone loss. But those are nonetheless just clinical indicators, which then the human can consume to come to a diagnosis and then to a treatment plan.
Right, right. Okay, and we're quickly running out of time, but I do have one more question for you. You know, if you're a dentist in practice, you're hearing a lot about this technology right now. How do you approach it? How do you evaluate it? How do you fit it into your practice? Now, I know that's a big question, and we only have 1 or 2 minutes left. But if you could just quickly address that.
Yeah, to keep it close, I would address it as almost the entire nation right now addresses ChatGPT to some extent, with an open mind, curiosity, and hey, how can I use this to leverage myself, right? And I think they did a great job because everyone tries it out. And that's exactly, I was just visiting several practices yesterday who uses OAI, and they embrace it. They want to understand it. They want to understand also what are the pitfalls of AI, what is AI, what are AI's limitations, and what are its strengths. And then you use it for your own benefit. So as an example, these dentists figured out this is amazing for case acceptance. So what they do is they look at the AI, then they hide the AI, show the x-ray to the patient, explain to them where the decay is. And then afterwards they say, and you know what, let me look at the AI if they confirm with me. They click on a button, the AI shows up exactly there, and it builds a huge trust. So figure out your own way how you want to work through this, but approach this with an open mind, curiosity, and it really can elevate your dental practice. If you know you're not afraid of it.
Yeah, and not to be a commercial, but the way you and we at Henry Schein One have implemented this, it's directly embedded within the practice software, so it's right inside that workflow, which I think just adds a great ease to the experience that the dental professional has. Well, believe it or not, we're out of time, Florian. This was absolutely terrific. You know, I could talk to you all day, and I love this stuff, and you do too. And I hope we've infected a few people in the audience to be more curious about it. Thanks again for your time today and chatting with us.
Thank you so much. Bye, Bruce. Bye, everyone.